Hi everyone and welcome to Bodyworks Prime. Today we're going to be going over the origin, insertion and action of the serratus anterior.
Here we can see an anterior view of the serratus anterior muscle, and the serratus anterior is deep to the pectoralis major and the pectoralis minor muscles. That means the pectoral muscles are going to be covering up the surface of the serratus anterior on this upper portion right here. Swapping to a posterior view now, you can see the serratus anterior is deep to the scapula, but it's also deep to the subscapularis muscle as well, meaning that the scapula and the subscapularis are covering that surface of the serratus anterior. Now we can see a lateral view of the serratus anterior. Let's move this muscle out of the way and take a look at the origins. Now we can see marked in red here the origin points, and that's on the first rib to rib 8 or 9. And you'll notice I said 8 or 9, and that's because there's some individual variation for how many origin points a person might have. One person might have their origins only up to the 8th rib here, and another person might have one extra, and they'll have all 9 of the origins. So here we can see an anterior view of the scapula, of the humerus, and of the clavicle. And ordinarily you'd have the rib cage just in front of the scapula here, but I've moved out of the way so you can more easily see this insertion which I've highlighted here in blue. So the serratus anterior's insertion is going to begin on the superior angle of the scapula, work its way down the scapula's medial border, and then finish on the inferior angle of the scapula.
So let's take a look at the actions next. Our first action is going to be protraction of the scapula. That's when the scapula comes forward, gliding across the surface of the ribs here towards the anterior of the body. I'll show you an example on myself. So my scapula is retracted right now, and the serratus anterior can contribute to pulling it forward into that protracted position. In addition to protraction, it can also cause rotation of the scapula. So those inferior fibers of the serratus anterior can pull on the scapula here, and that will result in a rotation of the scapula, which would move the glenoid cavity upwardly. The importance of that is because when the arm's up overhead right now, you can see we haven't had that rotation of the scapula. And you can see the acromion right here, the humerus is able to bump into it. We've also got the supraspinatus passing under this gap in the acromion here, and then that could get pinched. So people who have dysfunction or weakness in the serratus anterior, they tend to have pain when lifting their arm up overhead or pressing overhead. So in addition to that protraction and rotation, we've also got elevation of the ribs during respiration. It can also lift the ribs up when you're taking in a deep breath. Now, this isn't a primary action of the serratus anterior, it just plays an assistive role. It's able to help in that if it needs to. So if you've enjoyed the video or you found it helpful, you know which buttons to press. Press these buttons down there. It really helps our channel. As well, I've got some links in the description, so take a look at them because it goes to the full serratus anterior article on the website. That article's got more information about the serratus anterior, such as its innervation and blood supply. I've also got flashcards on there, so if you want to memorize this information about the serratus anterior, they're really useful for helping in that. Thanks again for watching, everyone. See you all next time.